Hello everybody, I'm sorry I haven't updated the channel a lot recently because I've been suffering from a bit of a Rocket League addiction.
Yes! That was a goal!
Twat! That was liquid football!
Shit! Did you see that? He must have a foot like a traction engine!
But enough of that, let's play a game of Afterburner Climax and blow out the old cobwebs! Time to select our aircraft. Well, the Tomcat was the aircraft in the original Afterburner, wasn't it? But I don't like to fly that, I like to fly the F-15 Strike Eagle, because I'm crazy that way. Which paint job shall we use? I think I'm going to use the camouflage. Which music am I going to choose? Obviously the music to Afterburner 2, because it's the original and the fucking best. Brave Fang Z is preparing launch of a nuclear weapon. Blah, 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 blah. Yakety schmackety exposition. Let's fly our planes. So what can I say about this? Afterburner Climax, in my opinion, the only true sequel to the original arcade games, released in 2006 by Sega, produced by the legendary AM2, and a potential 15 stages of absolute shooty bang bang joy. As much as I'd like to say that I'm playing the arcade version right now, obviously I'm not. I am playing the 2010 Xbox 360 port. And if you don't have a copy for your 360, I'm afraid it's tough titties, because it was delisted a year ago. Now, the 360 version had a load of unlockable EX options. All of those are turned off, aside from infinite credits and a bunch of extra lives, because I don't want to cheat that much. However, this isn't fucking one credit champ, so I'm just going to keep on going until I fucking finish this. I just need that sweet, sweet release. Let's face it, who doesn't need a climax now and again, eh? Eh? You know what I mean, lads? You know what I mean? Eh? 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 Now, the climax in the title of this game refers to the climax gauge. You shoot a bunch of enemies, the gauge gets higher and higher, until you can activate climax mode, time slows down, you have infinite rockets, you can paint all of the targets on the screen and then just unleash hell. Very much like that. There we go. Oh man, this game is so freaking beautiful looking, and as you've probably noticed, running at a full 60 frames per second. So any developer that claims that they can't get 60 FPS out of their games clearly has their priorities in the wrong fucking place, because teams like AM2 have been doing this shit for fucking donkey's years. Gonna have to stay very low in the canyon here and avoid all the explosions above me, and in a second I should be receiving my first special order. There we go, the prototype. I have to blow him up, obviously. There are multiple special orders in the game. If I complete all of them, I unlock an extra 2 stages at the end of the game. Because of that, there are 3 endings, an A, a B, and a C ending. You get the C ending if you do not do your special orders and unlock the last 2 stages, and the B and the A endings you get depending on how well you do in those last 2 stages. Where shall we go here? I think I'm going to pick the volcanic islands rather than the lure of the sky, because I really do like this level. It looks rather spiffing. I think what I'm going to do now is take this opportunity to give you a little bit of YouTube channel news. Now, I'm sure you've noticed I haven't been quite as active recently over the last couple of months. A whole load of real life pressures got in the way. You know, that pesky real life can be quite a chore sometimes. The problem is, once you stop doing something regularly, all of your motivation just fucking ceases. And I can't stand it, because I do want to give you loads of lovely freaking videos. You start second guessing yourself about what you should be doing. It's terrible, I tells thee. The reason why I'm doing this video instead of one credit champ is because I'm at an utter loss to what arcade machine I should cover next. I was looking at my shortlist and I realised how many of those games were made by Konami, and how much I really don't want to cover a Konami game at the moment, because, you know, fuck Konami. Even if the games of the 1980s and 90s were made by a very different version of that company with different business practices, what they've done recently manages to go back in time and tarnish anything good they've ever done. Think of all the wonderful characters they created. Lance Bean, Bill Riser, Poppin' Twinbee, Vic Viper, Lord British, The Snakes, The Belmonts, that bloke that looked like Hulk Hogan in Vendetta. All of them doomed to a future of themed patchy slot machines. And maybe the odd free-to-play mobile game. Ugh, how depressing, eh? So, oh audience of mine, what would you like to see me play? Not just for One Credit Champ, but in general. I mean, don't expect me to play an awful lot of those modern games. I mean, you know that I've got retro sensibilities, so if it is a modern game, think of the type of modern game that has that kind of retro edge to it, even if it's in the way it plays rather than the way it looks. For example, I enjoyed playing Action Henk because it had very similar mechanics to Sonic the Hedgehog. And, you know, I did enjoy that. Oh, hello, it's the Stealth Bomber. I'm going to chase him. I'm not going to beat him on this stage, but he does carry over to the next one as long as I stay close. Oh, for fuck's sake. Get that. Can't get fast. Fasty fast. Trigger not working. For fuck's sake. Where is he? He's still there. Good. He's still on the screen. Hopefully he's not too far away and he'll appear on the next stage. Come on. Yes, he's there. Excellent. I've got to take him out with my Vulcan cannon, which isn't that easy when you've got these bastards shooting missiles at you left, right and centre. You can tell how rusty I am at this game. By this point in time, I'm usually right on his arse and shooting it off. Blowing up doesn't fucking help either. Right, let's do this. Afterburner's engaged and let's shoot his bum off. And let's get this other plane out of the fucking way too. There we go. Oh shit, I've got a missile on my tail too. This does not make for a happy Mentus.
Does this make for an angry Mentus?
Oh, and you can cock off too, mate. Here we go, let's cause some freaking damage. No, no, don't fly away. No, no. If I don't blow him up by the end of the stage, I don't unlock the last two, and that won't be good. Oh, come on, I want to give you the full afterburner experience. Ah, there we go, good hit. Well done. Now we can relax until the next special order. God, I think I was a little bit lucky there. I don't think there's much more of this stage left. No, there isn't. We have finished this one. We got a selection here. I think I'm going to be picking Forgotten Glory. I'm pretty sure this is the Canyon stage, isn't it? Is it? Yes, it is. And I believe that this one has a special order in it too. I'm going to have to do this stage very slow and careful-like, because I'm pretty sure that the mission that I have to do involves me taking out a bunch of helicopters. Or at least I think it's that stage. I'm starting to second guess myself now, because there's not been any dialogue yet. Oh, here we go. Enemy ground troops are crossing the border. Stop them. Okay, we've got to take out these red targets, their little helicopter dropships. We've got to take it very, very slowly because they've got a habit of hiding around corners sometimes. Is there going to be one around here? No, thankfully not. Up to 6 out of 10 so far, 7 out of 10. And there is 3 more targets to get us our tally. And another one as well. There we go, we're 12 out of 10. We have done that special order. Oh, and look, there's one more sneakily hiding behind the corner. So we got 13 out of 10 there. The enemy's wounded and in full retreat. And we're in a sea of clouds. How lovely. As you probably noticed, by this point in the game, there are missiles freaking everywhere, and you can barely stop and target for a second. And believe me, it gets worse. We've got 3 stages to go, if not more. I'm surprised I haven't died a hell of a lot more, in all honesty. Oh, for fuck's sake. Just as I said it as well. Never forget Mentski's law. As soon as I say something's going well, the game will do something to shit in my face. But you know, whatever. As I said, this isn't a one credit champ. If I do lose all my lives, I'm just going to bloody continue anyway. I mean, I'd still like to finish it on one credit, because then I could probably get in the high scoreboard. Even though I started off with 9 lives. But you know, we'll see how it goes. We'll see how it goes, eh? Eh? Yeah. It's all going terribly at the moment. Oh God, and there's a missile behind me too. Whenever there is a missile on your tail or another plane, your wingmen actually tell you what you're supposed to do to avoid it. And I tend to ignore it completely.
They'll keep going like, break right, or something like that, and I'll try it. I have tried it in the past, but it never seems to bloody work, so what I tend to do is go full tilt for a couple of seconds and then put on the brakes, and usually it flies past me. I don't know if it did then or not. It seems to have disappeared. There you go. Did you hear her in the background? Break. I didn't need a bloody break. I don't know what she's on about. There we go. Anyway, that level's done. Here we go. Latest intel. The enemy's deployed a nuclear device on a prototype bomber and it's now mission capable. Don't worry about sympathetic detonation of the nuclear device. Engage and destroy the prototype with extreme prejudice. Good luck. Did that all in one breath then. That was a mistake. Anyway, this is another special orders stage. Stay low, avoid the lights and proceed with the mission. We've got to avoid all of these searchlights. Luckily, we can take an awful lot of them out with our missiles. If they catch a glimpse of me, they end up painting me as a target and it's fission mailed and I won't unlock those last two stages. And we got these laser detection things that are a pain in the ass. Luckily, we've got through though. From what I remember, we're not through the worst of it though, because come around this corner at some point and I'm pretty sure there is a huge grid of those laser detection things, and we need to use our climax gauge to get through them, because obviously it slows down time, and the climax gauge isn't working because I haven't got it up to the top. God, that was fucking lucky. Oh dear. Right, I think this is the end though now. Is it? I'm pretty sure it is. Yes, it is. Yes, good. Well, at least that special order is done and dusted too. Only a couple more of the main levels left, and this one is a complete pain in the ass. I have to keep on going in this X-like pattern to avoid all of these missiles being shot at me. And then at the end of each wave, try and take out as many as possible with the climax gauge. And then we start moving all over again. It really is quite unrelenting. If I stop for as much as a second, I will get absolutely fucking pasted. Please, let the torment stop. I really, really cannot stand this stage. Oh God, and I've got a bogey on my tail as well now. Let's give him a bit of the old push me, pull you. He's gone past me, hasn't he? I don't know. He did go past me. Thank God for that. There's nothing quite so bad as having a bogey on your tail after all. Unless it's one of those really nasty encrusted ones up your snotter, of course. Oh well, now we have the final stage, final line of defence or nuclear arsenal. I'm picking final line of defence because this is the stage where we take out the prototype jet with the nuclear weapon on it. If I'd have chosen the other side, it's a tunnel stage, and I don't really like tunnel stages that much. Too many bloody walls getting in the way, and the special order on that particular stage is very easy to fluff up. Whilst the one on this one is just the prototype jet. You take it down, you unlock the last two levels. So yeah, I'm taking the easiest path. But then again, I haven't really played this in over 6 months, so give me a fucking break. Here's the prototype bomber! Yay! Let's take this bastard out as soon as chuffing possible. Target hit! We've just prevented a nuke war. Nice one. So did we unlock the last two stages? Yes, we did. Warning, we're tracking a high-speed heat source inbound from the mainland. We've identified an aerial launch of a missile vectoring on our carrier group. Yes, Jaguar Flight Vector 4 missile and engage. Okay, so the aim of these last two stages, we have to take out these three missiles using only guns, because we can't lock onto them, before they hit our aircraft carrier. Not that it affects me that much if the aircraft carrier blew up. Unlike the Tomcat, in an F-15 you take off and land from an airfield. But what the hell, let's help out our old mates Maverick and Goose, shall we? Oh, shitting tits. Usually by this point I've only got one missile left and I've still got two to shoot down on the very last stage. This might prove difficult. We only have 27 seconds to take these bastards down and it's rapidly dropping by the second. And losing a life doesn't fucking help. I'm not going to catch up with these bastard missiles. Not a chance, I don't think. And we've got one on our tail as well. Oh, God, no. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Not going to get there. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's it. Oh, well, we're bingo and station. Disengaged. Mission complete, etc., etc., etc. Sadly, I don't get the A ending. But we do get this really neat little cutscene in a second, as soon as this is finished displaying. Here we go. Air alert warning, Seuss in operation. Intercept. See, they didn't need my bloody help anyway. They could blow them up with the guns on the carrier. All clear. Good, we only suffered a little damage. I was just informed that Z has made a full and unconditional surrender. The nuclear devices are secure. The recovery team has been deployed. Thanks to the brave men and women of Jaguar Flight, the world has been saved from a nuclear war. It was a tough mission, but you battled through and came out all right. The mission is a success. Indeed it is, and here we are, landing on our lovely airfield. Oh well, that's it then, innit, I guess. Fucking job done. Anywho, as I said earlier on in the video, if there are any games that you think I should be playing, either on One Credit Champ or otherwise, leave a message in the comments below and I'll see what I can do. Also, while I remember, this weekend, the 21st to the 23rd of August, I will be attending Play Margate down in Margate, of all places. So if you see me, wave hello or something. Anyway, let's put our name in. B and a U and the M and then press end. And what the fuck just happened there? It censored the word bum. What the fuck? Sometimes I don't know why I fucking bother. Oh well, the end. Until next time. Bye bye.